Now, he was a part of the core team that had launched Reliance India Mobile, and he's currently head brand and communications of ICICI Bank. He will be sharing his thoughts with us on crafting content for business outcomes. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome on stage Mr. Sujit Ganguli.
Good afternoon, everybody. You know, I was dreading when I was preparing for my presentation because I was told by the organizers my slot is at 2 o'clock. And that's like the graveyard slot immediately after lunch. It's normally very difficult to keep people awake. So I'm thankful that there has been a slot before me and after lunch. Thanks for that. And by the way, it was a brilliant presentation, the previous one. Very insightful. I'm going to talk about crafting content for business outcomes. So I want to show you two or three case studies of what we feel are good use of content within the bank to get good business outcomes. So a lot of videos on case studies coming up. I want to start off with this quote from Bill Bernbach. Bill Bernbach, in case people don't know, is one of the fathers of modern advertising, one of the three people who set up DDB about six decades back. When I read this quote, my feeling is that what he tried to say is that it's our job as marketeers to bring alive all the cold, hard facts of our business and make it alive and interesting for our consumers. If this quote was relevant in the 50s when he made it, I think it's 10 times more relevant now because of the context of the content that we operate in. As marketeers, when we are pushing out a content to people, what we have to realize is that the other content that our consumers are seeing are on such rich platforms. In fact, as one of my colleagues was joking, he said that don't be surprised while you're presenting. Maybe half the audience is already on these platforms and not listening to your presentation. So I said, I hope that is not the case. I hope they're listening to me. And as the previous presenter also said, a lot of the content is video. We are seeing serials, movies, sports, everything now. Whatever we want, it's on demand. And we can choose what we want to see. And not only is it video, on our social media platforms that we like, the content is customized. I get to see what I like. It could be food, it could be travel, it could be sports, it could be about social donations, it could be anything. So this is the context in which we advertisers, we marketeers will have to craft our content so that it can stand out and bring results for us. So what did we do? Sorry, before that, I mean, just a few things of what I feel is important, which is communicate your core message in a short attention span. This is something I forgot to mention in the last slide. I believe that on digital and social platforms, if you're not able to catch the consumer's attention in less than 2 or 3 seconds, we've lost the consumer. It takes less than a second to actually flick the feed and go to the next content on your phone. That's one. And second, of course, the dream for me is to produce content that can be shared. I have an example towards the end of my presentation of what we feel was good content and which got shared also on social media. Because ultimately that's earned content. Before I get on to my first example of home loans, I just thought this is the basic principle of marketing, which I don't think I need to tell to anybody here. But the only reason I have this slide is to say that what we learned 20 years back, 25 years back in RB school, I don't think the basic principles have changed. Maybe the techniques have changed, the formats have changed, maybe the tricks of the trade have changed, but the basic science of going for the audience, getting the insight, and reaching out to the right audience, I don't think that science has changed or will change in the immediate future. What did we do at ICICI Bank? As I said, we've got three examples. The first is home loans. So home loans, just a bit of a context. It's one of the largest businesses for us. It's one of the largest businesses in BFSI space. And also perhaps the largest investment decision that any one of us will make in our lifetimes. It's the largest, single largest investment decision for every family. One insight that we had from our research I think I've spoken a bit too soon. That insight is coming in the next slide. So let me go to the next slide itself. One of the insights we had from our research was that one common problem in urban India because of high costs of a flat, most people are ending up compromising on the type of flat that they're able to buy. If you want a 4 BHK, you end up buying a 3. If you want a 3 BHK, you end up buying a 2. So people are not able to buy the home that they dream. So we thought, is there something that we can do to help such people? The proposition we had was for salaried earners, 20% extra home loans, 20% extra than standard eligibilities of ICICI Bank or any other bank in the market. We were doing this by discounting the future income of the next 5 years. So we said, if you're a salaried earner, we know how much your income will be after 5 years. Basis that, I can give you up to 20% extra loan right now. And we produced some ads. The creative insight we used was lack of space at home can lead to certain inconveniences. We deliberately used humor to break through the clutter. Remember what I talked about Bill a few minutes back. It's very important to be able to generate content that's engaging. So, and home loan is, it's an important category, but definitely not the most interesting of categories. So we said, let's use humor to be able to break through the clutter. So I have a TV example, but very soon after this, I'll move on to an activation that we did online. Can we play the video, please?
सोच रहा हूं आज छुट्टी ले लूं, तुम भी ले लो, बॉस को बोल देता हूं कि तबीयत खराब है. दीदी का सुबह सुबह जुम्बा शुरू हो गया है तो इसलिए
ठीक है सो जाना.
बच्चे जब बड़े हो तो उनको खुद का कमरा मिले, इसलिए ICICI बैंक लाया है स्टेप अप होम लोन, जो देगा आपको आपकी एलिजिबिलिटी से 20% तक ज्यादा लोन.
सो हाउ डिड द वीडियोस परफॉर्म? वन ऑफ कोर्स वी गॉट द व्यूज दैट वी वांटेड, बट व्हाट वाज मोर सैटिस्फाइंग फॉर मी वाज दैट व्हेन वी लुक्ड एट द यूट्यूब डेटा, एंड वी नो ऑन यूट्यूब पीपल कैन स्किप द फिल्म आफ्टर 10-15 सेकेंड्स. The completion rate of this was in the top decile of all BFSI ads, which to me was a proof that yes, even when people can switch off the ad, people are not switching it off and watching the ad till the end, which means the message is getting delivered. We did some print also. I think it's plain vanilla print. I don't need to spend time on it. We also used for the first time in BFSI, pre-rolls linked to search. I'll just show the example and then I'll explain to you what I mean by it. Can we have the short video, please? So if you see the last screen here, we were actually trying to drive search in this through the 12-second pre-roll. We believe we're the first to do it. It has become a YouTube case study. It's subsequently been done by a lot of other players. And it brought us huge results, which I'll show in just a minute from now. This is an activation that we did purely on digital. The activation, of course, happened in the malls, but it was purely leveraged on digital. And I'll show you the activation and the results that we got out of it. It's for the same product. Yeah, please.
The most populous country in the world. 10 out of 20 most overcrowded cities in the world are in India. Indians adjust. And they adjust everywhere, every day.
Beti separate room mangti hai, lekin possible nahi hai. We adjust.
Introducing The Bench. Powered by ICICI Bank, Step Up Home Loans. 20% higher eligibility on your home loans.
बड़ा घर मिल जाए ये तो सबका सपना होता है।
मेरी दो बेटियां हैं तो मैं डेफिनेटली थोड़ा स्पेस ज्यादा मिलेगा और मैं बड़ा घर लेना चाहूंगा।
This bench video alone got 11 million views, and what I'm proud about the fact is that a lot of this happened because of shareability. We didn't put too much of monies behind on social media to get this. 37 million people reached total impressions, and about 3,000 people experienced the bench in the malls and the parks. To me, in my experience in banking and banking marketing and financial services marketing, this is one of the better ones that at least we have done. I'm not commenting on the others, but this is one of the better ones we have done where, because of virality, we were able to get reach and being able to get our message across. My topic says crafting content for business outcomes, so I don't think it will be complete if I don't show the outcome. We got 6x increase in brand queries in this short period. Please understand that we have always been one of the largest home loan players, so there is no dearth of people searching for us. Despite that, our numbers shot up 6x in a short span. Call center inquiries went up 14x. And in the very next quarter that we did it, our market share moved up by 200 basis points. In a 15-player category, all of whom are competing very hard, moving up 200 basis points in a quarter, we felt proud of it. I think in the interest of time, I'll not summarize it because as I'm seeing the clock, there's only 11 minutes to go. But basically we feel it's a good insight and a clutter-breaking creative that gave us the content, gave us the outcomes that we wanted. Second one is Ferrari credit cards. This is a card, the co-branded card that we launched with Ferrari sometime last year. I believe it's the first of its kind in Asia, definitely the first in India. So here the key feature of this card, there were two key features. First is Ferrari car lovers could go online and buy the online merchandise at discounted rates from the Ferrari site. And the second, the bigger one, was the top spenders would be able to go to Ferrari, experience the museum, experience the racetrack, and have an experience of the lifetime. So it might not appeal to everybody, but for the hardcore Ferrari fans who are a decent size in India, this was, we felt, a powerful proposition. So we did the usual stuff, what all of us in digital marketing do, search ads, display, GIF ads, I mean all the regular stuff that our agencies and platforms recommend to us. We did all of that. We were all on the display platforms. Now, the main thing that I want to highlight is this, which is we roped in Nikhil Chinnappa and we made a video journal of several episodes showcasing the experiences of the people who were the first batch to go to the Ferrari Museum in Italy. And this again became viral for us on various social media platforms, purely through content. Can we have this short video, please?
Hey guys, so today we're in the Enzo Ferrari Museum. Now, the museum itself has two buildings. The older building is where Ferrari was born and his father had his workshop. The newer building is a massive showcase for everything Ferrari. Take a look. The F1 Ferrari simulator, which everybody has been trying out. I'm going to give it a shot. That was absolutely wild, but trust me, that's one way not to drive a Ferrari.
This is just a short clip that I showed. We are actually, this is a multi-episode journal, but I'm just showing one for the sake of time. We also had a regular carousel ads that I'm sure all of us do to get the numbers in. The results of this was 9.8 million views of only this. This is the only video that we produced. We didn't have any other normal ad for this. So this experience video gave us about 10 million views, 800,000 clicks on the page for the Ferrari card. And this also was an example of generating views and reach a lot through sharing. Of course, I would be wrong to say that we didn't spend money, We did spend money, but a lot of it came through sharing. And the last example that I have of, so this is strictly not business in the sense of business. This is a CSR campaign. But how did we use clever advertising and marketing techniques to be able to do some good to society? So this is called a Gift a Livelihood campaign. The background to it is that ICICI group, we do our CSR activities through ICICI Foundation, and we run one of the largest skill training programs in the country. We run it completely free. These are three-month programs in blue-collar skills and white-collar skills. We run it in about 24 centers across the country. About 300,000 people have been skilled with 100% employment guarantee, not a guarantee, 100% employment placement record as of now. So what we said is that we need candidates also, right? We need candidates, deserving candidates for these academies across the country. So to boost enrollments in this training center, we launched this campaign asking people to nominate deserving candidates to the academies. And we call this campaign Gift a Livelihood. Now, what was the insight? Why did we believe this campaign would be a success? The insight is that if I take the example of the recent Kerala floods, a lot of us felt bad for the people there in Kerala, right? And a lot of us wanted to help. But none of us would be, or very few of us would be willing to leave our jobs and our family and houses in Bombay and land up in Kerala and help, right? It's not possible. It's not physically possible. So we are looking for conduits and NGOs or tools, facilities where we can actually contribute sitting here. It's not always possible for everybody to go and volunteer, but if the right conduit is there, we can. And I'm sure a lot of us have done it for Kerala. The insight here was the same, that people want to help others, but they don't know how to. They don't have the wherewithal to do it. So if you give them a simple tool, then they might be able to help other needy people. That was the insight that we were working on. So this is the last video that I'm going to show. It's about 2 minutes. Please bear with me. I hope all of you like it. Can we have the video, please?
Hey, Raddi! Yeah, upar!
एक सेकंड यार, ये किताब नहीं बेचनी, इसको निकाल दे।
निकाल दो सर, फालतू में घर में पड़ी रहेगी।
ये नहीं बेचनी, बाकी तोल दे तो।
15 किलो सर।
ठीक है।
दे दो सर, 10-15 रुपए ज्यादा दे दूंगा उसकी।
कहा तो सर, नहीं बेचनी किताब, इसके पैसे दे दे बस।
सर ये ले। एक्सक्यूज मी सर।
क्या हुआ?
प्लीज सर, कैन आई बोरो दिस बुक सर? सर प्लीज सर।
यार अच्छे खासे पढ़े लिखे लगते हो, तो फिर ये रद्दी का काम क्यों कर रहे हो तुम?
आपके लिए ये रद्दी है सर, मेरे लिए बीए एमए की डिग्रियां हैं सर, जो भी पढ़ा हूं इसी से पढ़ा हूं सर।
नाइस, काफी कमाल के आदमी लगते हो यार। एक काम करो, अंदर आ जाओ, तुम्हारी रद्दी के बारे में बात करते हैं। हाँ दोस्त, बताओ अपने एमए और बीए की डिग्री के बारे में।
सर पापा पढ़े लिखे थे नहीं, उनका रद्दी का काम था।
अच्छा।
मगर हमें पढ़ाना चाहते थे। मैं जब 14 साल का था तब उनकी डेथ हो गई। छोटा भाई 8 साल का था, मम्मी हाउसवाइफ, तो घर चलाने के लिए मुझे ये रद्दी का काम चलाना पड़ा। स्कूल छूट गया मगर मैंने पढ़ाई नहीं छोड़ी सर। के बाद ना सर मैंने रद्दी पकड़ ली। रद्दी को पढ़ना शुरू किया, रद्दी से सीखना शुरू किया। एक सपना था सर, थोड़ा और जान लू, थोड़ा और सीख लू। वो कहते हैं ना सर, नेवर स्टॉप ड्रीमिंग।
कमाल हो यार।
और इलेक्ट्रिकल चीजों में ज्यादा इंटरेस्ट है सर, इसलिए ये बुक आप मुझे पढ़ने को दे दो तो आई विल बी थैंकफुल सर।
क्या आदमी हो, मजा आ गया सच में। यू कैन कीप दिस बुक, पर मुझे 2 दिन में वापस चाहिए।
2 दिन बहुत है सर इसे खत्म करने के लिए।
श्योर
श्योर सर।
चलो
थैंक यू सर।
कुछ सपने लायक होते हैं पूरा होने के। जब आपको ऐसा कोई सपना दिखे जिसे देख उसे पूरा करने का मन करे, तो जाइए giftalivelihood.com पर। वो सपना हमें रेफर कीजिए, अपने खर्च पर ICICI Academy for Skills में इलेक्ट्रिकल रिपेयर या ऑफिस एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन जैसी स्किल बेस्ड ट्रेनिंग देकर उसे एक अच्छी नौकरी, एक बेहतर जिंदगी के लिए तैयार करने की जिम्मेदारी हमारी है।
सर, सर।
अरे मनोज, कैसा है?
थैंक यू सर।
क्या ये? अच्छा, लेटर आ गया?
आ गया सर।
डियर मनोज कुमार, वेरी नाइस।
यस सर, आपने नई जिंदगी दे दी सर। थैंक यू सर।
कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशन सर।
थैंक यू।
ऑल द बेस्ट।
तो आइए पूरा करते हैं वो सपने जो लायक हैं पूरा होने के।
If you notice at the beginning of the video, this guy, when he calls the other guy, he says, "Hey, Raddi, idhar aana." It's pretty common. I don't know if you noticed it or not, but it's pretty common behavior amongst us, right? I mean, people who do such jobs, we don't even consider them people of our level. So we call them Raddi, kachra wala idhar aana. That's the way we address. But actually, they also have aspirations and they can also do well. If I had more time, I could have spoken more about a lot of such real-life examples that we have. Examples of transformation. So on social media, we showcase some of them also. People who have come from, like this guy, he was a waiter in a small, very small restaurant, a tier 3 town in India. Today he's an AC technician running his own shop in Pune. This girl, part of a large family in Manipur, she used to break stones, physically use a hammer to break stones to earn a living. Today she is working in a call center, and from there she's become an office executive. Daily wage earner to a sales executive in one of the large white good outlets in Bangalore. So that's been the transformation that we've seen. And so while we've did a subsequent campaign on our CSR activities a few months back where we put in a good amount of budgets, but this was an activity which was, we were just testing waters. We did not put in too much of money, and we wanted to see how is it received. Happy to see that we got 3.5 million views. 26,000 shares. As I was saying in the beginning, if the content is good, people share, and that's what gets the virality and the reach. And in the first 2 months, we got 22,000 plus referrals, valid referrals. We got many more, but referrals of people who are valid and who can be accepted in our institutes, about 22,000. So in conclusion, I think it's very simple. Get the audience, get the insight right. As I said, core marketing principles don't change. Whatever be the medium, get the insight right. Keep that creative interesting, because the consumer is not sitting to watch our ad. He or she has tons of other options. So if the creative is not interesting, we will be missed. We will not be seen. Have prominent call for actions wherever required. And finally, keep experimenting, keep doing new things. Only then will you get success. Thank you.
Yes, so we're running.
I think I've exceeded my time, so maybe I can handle the questions later in the interest of time. It's actually a good thing to exceed so that one doesn't have to answer this.
Quite a point. So please stay with me. I'd like to invite Lara Balsara Bajiftar, Executive Director, Madison World. Please join me on stage to hand over the memento to Mr. Ganguli. So please take center stage. Let's have a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. That was a fantastic presentation. Thank you very much, sir.